Hi, greetings to you all. I am Dr. A. Venkatnarayana, Associate Professor, Department of Biotechnology, Vignan Foundation for Science, Technology and Research. Today, I would like to discuss about temperature-dependent thermorate equation from Arrhenius' law and various reactor types. Before going to the contents of the topic, it is with help of this Arrhenius equation, we can find out the rate constant and activation energy of the reaction. And rate constant is the temperature dependent thermorate equation. When temperature changes, rate constant is also changes. And activation energy is the minimum amount of energy required for the reactant molecules to produce the desired products. And also in this topic, we are going to discuss about various reactor types easy to carry out the chemical reaction or biochemical reaction. Contents of the today's topic are Arrhenius equation, significance of frequency factor and activation energy, Arrhenius plot, conclusions drawn from Arrhenius equation, on various reactor types, exercise, followed by summary. Objective of the topic is to analyze the temperature dependent term of rate equation from Arrhenius' law. After completion of this topic, students will be able to understand Arrhenius' equation, know the significance of frequency factor and activation energy, analyze Arrhenius' plot, understand conclusions drawn from Arrhenius equation and analyze various reactor types. Temperature dependency from Arrhenius law. For many reactions, particularly element reactions, rate expression or rate of reaction is function of the two terms. First one is the temperature dependent term, the other one is the composition of the reactant molecules, nothing but concentration of the reactant molecules. This can be written as Ri is equal to rate of formation of the component I is equal to F1 of temperature into F2 of composition. So here the function of temperature can be represented with rate constant in reactions. So this equation can be modified as Ri is equal to K into function of composition, that is nothing but concentration of reactant molecules. Here the rate constant in reactions always follows the Arrhenius equation. This Arrhenius equation, you already know that K is equal to K naught into e to the power of minus E by RT. Here K naught is the frequency factor and E is called the activation energy of the reaction. The frequency factor tells about the number of collisions between the reactant molecules. And here E is called the activation energy. It tells about the minimum amount of energy required for the reactant molecules to produce the desired products. And R is the universal gas constant. Its value is 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. And T is the reaction temperature. So here this Arrhenius equation can be written at two temperatures. Then at T is equal to T1, assume the rate constant K1. At T is equal to T2, assume the rate constant K2. Then Arrhenius equation becomes, for this Arrhenius equation, apply the natural logarithm ln on both sides. Then this equation becomes ln K is equal to ln of mn becomes ln m plus ln n. So here ln of K0 into e to the power of minus e by RT can be written as ln K0 plus ln of e to the power of minus e by RT. So this equation at temperature T1 becomes, at temperature T1 rate constant is K1, ln K1 is equal to ln K0 plus ln e to the power of minus e by RT1. At temperature T2, this equation becomes ln K2 is equal to ln K0 plus ln e to the power of minus e by RT2. Now after this, subtract the equation 1 from equation 2, then we get, first subtract the equation 1 from equation 2 on left hand side, the ln k2 minus ln k1, and then do the subtraction on right hand side, ln k0 plus ln of e to the power of minus e by rt2 minus ln k0 plus ln of e to the power of minus e by rt1. So on left hand side, ln m minus ln n, ln m by n, here you can write this as ln k2 by k1. On right hand side, ln k0 and minus ln k0 both becomes cancelled. So ln e to the power of minus e by rt2 can be written as minus e by rt2 as per the formula ln a to the power of x base a is equal to x. Similarly, ln e to the power of minus e by rt1, that becomes minus e by rt1. Already we have a minus before, minus minus becomes plus. Then in the next step, on right hand side, take e by r common, then that equation becomes ln k2 by k1 is equal to e by r into 1 by t1 minus 1 by t2. So in chemical reactions, rate constant is directly proportional to the rate of reaction. I already said that minus Ra is equal to the k C A to the power of n for nth order reaction. So k is directly proportional to the rate of reaction. So this can be written as ln R2 by R1, since k directly related to the rate of reaction, and k is inverse related to the temperature. And here minus Ra is equal to k C A to the power of n, minus Ra can be written as minus dt d C A by dt. The rate of reaction units are mole per meter cube per second. Mole per meter cube is concentration by time. So here rate of reaction and time are inversely related, and rate constant and time are also inversely related. So in place of this one, you can write ln R2 by R1 is equal to ln T1 by T2, that equal to ln K2 by K1 is equal to E by R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. With help of this equation, once if you know the rate constant at a particular temperature, you can find out the rate constant at other temperature. Or if you want to find out the activation energy of the reaction, once if you know the two rate constant at two different temperatures, you can find out the activation energy of the reaction. For any given reaction, activation energy is constant. Activation energy can be reduced with help of the catalyst, but rate constant is temperature dependent term. When temperature changes, rate constant changes. So this is the Arrhenius plot. So after applying the natural logarithm to the Arrhenius equation, we can obtain the equation as ln k is equal to ln k0 minus e by rt. So this is of the form y is equal to mx plus c. In place of the y, here we have the ln k. In place of the x, we have the 1 by t, and slope is minus e by r, that is negative slope. When you plot the graph between ln k versus 1 by t, you can obtain a straight line with a negative slope. You can obtain high slope for high activation energy and low slope for low activation energy. So with the help of this Arrhenius plot, you can find out the frequency factor k0 and activation energy if you have the experimental data of L, that means k versus temperature, rate constant versus temperature. Here next one, we have the table showing the temperature rise needed to double the rate of reaction. So here this table is generated based on certain experiments in laboratory. Here first column represents the average temperature. The second column, that means represents the at low activation energy 40 kilojoule per mole. Third column at 160 kilojoule per mole activation energy. Fourth column at 280 kilojoule per mole, and followed by 400 kilojoule per mole. At initial at low temperature 0 degree centigrade and at low activation energy, if I raise the temperature to 11 degree centigrade, and rate of reaction is getting double. Similarly, at high activation energy 400 kilojoule per mole at 0 degree centigrade, if I raise only the 1.1 degree centigrade, our rate of reaction is getting double. Based on this one, we can say that reactions are temperature sensitive at high activation energy, and reactions are temperature insensitive at low activation energy. And similarly, at 0 degree centigrade, at 40 kilojoule per mole low activation energy, if I raise the temperature to 11 degree centigrade, rate of reaction is getting double. When you take the same reaction at 2000 degree centigrade at low activation energy 40 kilojoule per mole, how much temperature we need to rise to double the rate of reaction? We need to rise the 744 degree centigrade to double the rate of reaction. So based on this one, we can say reactions are temperature sensitive at low temperature, and reactions are temperature insensitive at high temperature. Conclusions drawn from Arrhenius equation. From Arrhenius plot of LNK versus 1 by T gives a straight line for, that means with large slope for large E and small slope for small E, that is small activation energy. And reactions with high activation energy are temperature sensitive, and reactions with low activation energy are temperature insensitive. At any given reaction is much more temperature sensitive at low temperature than at a high temperature. That is, reactions are temperature sensitive at low temperature and reactions are temperature insensitive at high temperature. From Arrhenius law, the frequency factor K naught does not affect the temperature sensitivity of the reactions. Reactor types. Based on the contacting flow patterns of the reactants, reactors are broadly classified into two types. First one is the unsteady state reactors and second one is the steady state reactors. In unsteady state reactor, the composition or concentration varies with respect to the time. Best example is batch reactor. In steady state flow reactors, the composition or concentrations do not vary with respect to the time. The examples are plug flow reactor and mixed flow reactor. First one, batch reactor. In batch reactor, before start of the reaction, we send all the reactants at a time into the reactor. Once the reaction completes, then only we remove the products. We carry out the reaction in batch reactor in closed vessel, in which the composition or concentration of the reactants varies with respect to the time. But at any particular time, the composition is uniform throughout the reactor. Plug flow reactor is tubular reactor. In tubular reactor, when fluid or reactant molecules flow through the reactor, there is no overtaking of early entry fluid with the late entry fluid. There is no overtaking of the fluid elements with one another. And here, that means the concentrations or compositions do not vary with respect to the time at any particular length. When length changes, automatically the concentrations or compositions changes. Based on this one, we can say that means the PFR is steady with respect to the time and PFR is unsteady with respect to the length. The other steady state reactor is mixed flow reactor. In MFR, we continuously pass the reactant and we continuously remove the products. So here, in MFR, we maintain highly mixing conditions with help of the stator impeller. So here, in MFR, the compositions do not vary with respect to time as well as position because of high mixing conditions. Exercise, here these are the problems on Arrhenius law. First one, milk is pasteurized if it is heated to 63 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. But if it is heated to 74, same effectiveness of the sterilization process in 15 seconds. Find the activation energy of the sterilization process. Here, initially he heated milk at 63 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. To obtain the same effectiveness, that means at 74 degrees centigrade, it only takes 15 seconds. And he asked to find out the activation energy of the sterilization process. Here, that means we have the temperature T1 given, 63 degrees centigrade, and time taken by the sterilization process given, and temperature T2 74 degrees centigrade given, and time taken by the sterilization process given. Convert seconds to be minutes, and then use the formula, Arrhenius law formula, time versus temperature. The equation is ln of small time T1 by T2 is equal to E by R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. So here R value is 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. You can use that formula, you can use that value, and you can find out the activation energy required for the sterilization process. Second one, at 500 Kelvin, the rate of bimolecular reaction is 10 times the rate at 400 Kelvin. He asked to find out the activation energy from the Arrhenius law. So here, the rate of the bimolecular reaction at 500 Kelvin is 10 times the rate at 400 Kelvin. The rate we always represent in reactions with help of the rate constant, that when you take the 500 Kelvin as T2 temperature, rate constant K2 is equal to 10 times the K1. We can have the relationship between K2 versus K1. K2 by K1 is equal to 10, and T1 is given as 400 Kelvin. With the help of this one, you can find out the activation energy by using the formula ln K2 by K1 is equal to E by R into 1 by capital T1 minus 1 by capital T2. The pyrolysis, third one, the pyrolysis of ethane process with an activation energy of about 300 kilojoule per mole. how much faster is the decomposition at 650 than at 550. Here the fastness of the reaction we always tell in terms of the rate constant. So here he is asking to relate rate constant K2 to the K1, relationship between K2 to the K1, and information provided is activation energy given and temperature T1 500 degrees centigrade given and temperature T2 650 degrees centigrade given. So here with the help of this one, because by using the formula ln K2 by K1 is equal to E by R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2, you can bring the relationship between K2 to the K1. In all these, that means the problems, you need to convert temperature degree centigrade to the Kelvin. Why? Because R value is in terms of the Kelvin. R is equal to 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. Last one, at 1100 Kelvin, N known end thermally cracks 20 times as rapidly as at 1000 Kelvin. Find out the activation energy for this reaction. So T2 value given 1100 Kelvin, T1 1000 Kelvin, and here the K2 is given as 20 times the K1. Again, similar to the previous one, you can find out the activation energy of the reaction. Next one, summary, Arrhenius equation. The temperature dependent term in rate constant we always represent with Arrhenius equation. K is equal to K0 into e to the power of minus E by RT. K0 is the frequency factor and E the activation energy of the reaction. And frequency, significance of the frequency factor or the activation energy. The frequency factor tells about the number of bonds between the reactant molecules, and the activation energy, the that means the minimum amount of energy required for the reactant molecules to produce the desired products. Arrhenius plot of LNK versus 1 by D gives a straight line with a negative slope. That means the slope is very high for high activation energy and the slope is low for low activation energy. And conclusions drawn from Arrhenius equation, from a plot of LNK versus 1 by T gives a straight line with high slope for high E and low slope for low E. And second conclusion is, reactions are temperature sensitive at high activation energy and reactions are temperature insensitive at low activation energy. And third one, reactions are temperature sensitive at low temperature and reactions are temperature insensitive at high temperature. And fourth one, the K0 frequency factor K0 does not affect the temperature sensitivity of reactions. Reactor types, that means here we have mainly three types of the reactors: batch reactor, plug flow reactor, and mixed flow reactor. In batch reactor, the concentration changes with respect to the time, but at any particular time, the concentration is uniform throughout the reactor. In PFR, the concentration changes with respect to the length. The concentration do not vary with respect to the time. In mixed flow reactor, the concentration do not vary with respect to the time as well as position. Thank you.